How did it go today?
Pretty well.
Yeah.
Pretty good to the simulator. You couldn't ask for a better simulation than we're dealing with situations out there, especially in the wild world.
You've come down before.
Yeah, I've come down before.
Yeah, yeah. What was it like on the test well?
It's very similar. Yes, it's very similar. It's very lifelike. It replicates a lot of the situations that you will run into. Yeah.
I heard you got pumped down.
No.
I mean, pumped
off.
Oh,
yes. I got pumped off. Today. That's right. That's right. It's one of those situations that I've never got to experience, you know. What happens when you get pumped off? You know, when someone's trying to simulate it and trying to mimic it and replicate it, it's very accurate. I would highly recommend this school to anybody that's looking to get some training.
Awesome. What did you learn being pumped off that you can apply in the real world? What would you do different?
What would I do differently? Take away that board that you're blinding me from. Yeah, so one of the ways that they'll get you to concentrate on all your gauges and your weight and your collars is they'll put a board up in the back so you don't concentrate on the spool, you know. And you know, one thing you got to look for when you know you start getting hung up on the top of the float tubes is that the ship will jump. Well, if you can't see that the ship's jumping, you know, obviously the only thing you got to go off is the indicator. But the school's really similar, and I would highly recommend this to anybody who's looking to get more training in. This is very accurate, very good school.
We have had guys come through here that said they've learned years of experience in just a few days.
Yeah, that is true, because the thing is, like, there's no training for this. Yeah. You can't, the only way I learned how to pump down is I'd watch my engineer, and one day, hey, it's your turn. And it's very intimidating because it's a real world situation. And over here, we can mimic a lot of the situation you're gonna run to out in the wireline world.
Well, that's the goal. Paris, hi. What did you get from this?
I've been pumping down for like good 3 years now, but this thing, like, you know, Christian mentioned most of the stuff, but like the way I got stuck and we had to search the well. Yes, like, you know, we have done it in the real world, but the way, like, you know, Russell taught us and the way, like, you know, we have to apply tension and speed like that, it was a new, completely new world for me. How we do it and the way we got unstuck and then we were dragging on the plug, coming out of the hole, it was great. Other than that, the pump down, like, you know, it's really challenging. Guys, you think, like, you know, there's a pipe laying down for just 2,200 feet. No, it is really challenging, like the curve, going uphill, going downhill, it's a challenge. And I learned really a lot from this thing. Means, again, I've been doing it for 3 years. These situations we don't counter like every day. It's like once a year, once in 6 months. Here, you do it every other run. And they train you for like when these kind of situation happens. Like the company man is sitting right next to you, he's yelling at you, what would you do at that time? So that's really good school, that's really good simulation. Like, you know, the way the tension is going up and down, you have to control your speed. I learned a lot. I'll just say in short, like, you know, I learned a lot from this school. Yeah.
I love it. Thank you, Nurse. And Javi, our 30-year veteran plus.
Hello,
what
everybody.
What is your goal in educating these guys on pump down?
Well, my expectations, like Juan said, I did this for 30 years. My expectation is for them to be better than me when I get out. Better than me, just an experience. They probably better than me already with the new technology. Anyways, it's exciting coming to this training every time. It's exciting to see these guys.